What's going on, everybody? This is DJ B-Rye with Funkytown Entertainment, back at it again with another gig log. Today we're doing a wedding. This wedding's going to be here in Iredell, Texas. It's just outside of Hyco. It's about an hour and 15 minutes away from me in Fort Worth. A little bit of a drive, but definitely don't mind it. Pretty drive down, so definitely like that. But yeah, so we are here at the 7X Oaks Wedding Event Venue. This is my first time at this venue, so you guys can be seeing it for the first time just like I will. It's a really cool venue that I like. I like it a lot already. It's pretty cool. Let me tell you, though, it is what I call country with a K. It's really out here in the middle of nowhere. Very country, rustic vibes. So it should be an interesting one. It's going to be a hot one. There is no AC in a open door barn kind of style reception area. They have like four giant big like portable fans that's going to be supplying the AC today, so we will see how that goes. But yeah, they have a little covered area right here. We're not using this for anything, but right behind me is the ceremony area right here outside, and then back behind this building right here is going to be the actual reception venue. I'll go ahead and walk you guys through my setup. Don't know how much dancing and how much we're really gonna have a lot of today. It's gonna be probably mostly a country style wedding with a lot of country music. I know for us DJs, there's not a whole lot to do when it comes to mixing on that, which is totally fine. I wonder how much dancing footage I'm gonna get for you guys. If not, I'll just kind of put a montage together for you to kind of see what all happens. But I'm gonna go ahead and take you inside so you can see the reception, the ceremony, and the two rigs that I'm using for it. Alright y'all, so I'm actually doing a voiceover on this video today because they got me in the corner, people are walking around, and also they got me right next to that big giant fan, which is super loud. But so you guys are actually looking at my my country kind of look with my facade. I actually built this little DIY project. It's basically some fake wood paneling that you can buy at Home Depot or Lowe's, and I cut them to size to fit each panel of the facade. And I have Velcro on the top, on the sides, on the bottom, and on that other side right there, just to kind of keep them in place. But usually I have my white fabric in there, but today the couple wanted more of a country look, and honestly the wood fits really well with the rest of the venue. So, and that's on the Pro X 5 panel facade. And then as we come around the board, you'll go ahead and see the rest of my setup, which is pretty normal. Not much has changed at all. Definitely rolling with my DDJ 1000 SRT running Serato. Also using my 2017 MacBook on the Magma laptop stand. Once again, I use Serato for my software. I'm also using my Allen & Heath ZI-10 mixer. And I'm going to put my Sennheiser EWD wireless microphone on this rack right there after the ceremony. Got my Airstream DMX bridge from ADJ. And the transmitter is going to be talking to those receivers up there, blinking the donor wireless receivers on my Wash FX 2s. I have one up top on that one speaker, and then also on the other speaker. I then have my iPad that runs all the scenes that I've created within the Airstream DMX app. And then I have my V-Moda headphones, which I am absolutely loving. They're fantastic. Got my logo right there. Get a lot of compliments on those from all my guests whenever they come up to me. I also have another iPad that I use for backup music, and then also the cocktail hour so I can go help do other things. There we go. Got the gooseneck mic set up from Kevin from Mobile DJ Remaster. Took his idea. I love it. And then I got some gravity clips right there. It's got to keep all the cable management as simple and easy, not having to use duct tape or anything. And then I got a Furman power strip or power conditioner to have everything plugged into for a safe reading for power. And then right there, I got the Whataburger Yeti. You cannot forget that. And then here's my pile where I've just kind of stuffed everything in the corner, trying to keep it all nice and tidy since I'm back here in the corner. But yeah, here's the setup. Here's the view I'm going to have for the evening. It's definitely going to be a hot one. You'll see for sure.
Not a lot of AC, actually no AC, just the powerful fans that they have there. So we will see how everything goes for the night, and I'm going to go ahead and keep you guys coming along with the evening.
All right, everybody, so that's the reception venue. As you can see, it's pretty country. It's actually pretty loud, as you can tell, because also got a lot of fans everywhere. Got one fan right there. Got another one right behind me there. And then I got the big old AC monster unit right next to me. Right up, get my hand, there it is, inverted. All right, she's right there, right next to my setup, but what can you do? We'll be all right. One thing that I always recommend, especially in Texas or just in DJing in the summertime / going into fall season, bring a fan. That sucker is mine. Usually I put it on the ground next to me, but what I went ahead and did, there's a hole in this thing, so I just have it propped up, beaming right at my face the whole time while I'm DJing. So since that fan right in front of me, the big one, is not gonna touch me, I at least brought my own right here so I don't just sweat and die all night. But it's gonna be fun for sure. Definitely excited for it. Yeah, pro tip, always bring a fan. Alright everybody, so I'm here at the ceremony setup. I'll go ahead and show you guys what I got rolling today. It's the same thing I usually have, still wanting to try to make it a nice, clean, and concise thing, but still trying to strategize what kind of ceremony build that I want to do. Excuse the sweat, like I said, it's hot. So let me go ahead and show you guys what I'm rolling with. We got the Yamaha MG06X, the compact mixer. I went with this just because it's a very simple to use mixer. Not a whole lot of gadgets and gizmos that you need. Like, no, I have like some effects, but I rarely will use them outside, especially. Right here though, so I have my wireless microphone, which is my Sennheiser EWD unit. That is gonna be right here. Have the half wave antennas, so that way it gets a better reach than the little baby quarter wave antennas that usually come with it. They're gonna be right there in the middle, so shouldn't be too bad of a line of sight. And I will be using the lapel pack on it, so I'm gonna put it right on the efficient and everything should go smoothly. I really do like this unit a lot. I know I talk about it in my other videos. It's a good stable unit. Just always make sure you do your frequency scan beforehand. And I always recommend right before as well, whenever the guests get here, because cell phones are now in the picture. Rather than when you test it an hour before everybody shows up. But the laptop, I'm gonna be rolling my normal laptop right here on this shelf, which by the way, these shelves are from this company right here, audio2000s.com. They are just the perfect size to clamp onto right here, to clamp onto your speaker pole. So if you need a shelf, definitely look that up. I think I got them on Amazon. They're pretty good. But yeah, kind of just trying to, probably gonna move everything, keep it out of the sun. The sun's gonna be beating down on us right there, but it's not too hot right now when the sun's going down. So yeah, this is gonna be the setup right here. Amanda and Chase are gonna be right there in the beautiful view. So definitely looking forward to it. And just to so you know, so you guys kind of see it from the front, right there, just kind of keep it out the way. I always recommend trying to be off to the side enough to where if the photographer takes a wide angle shot, you might not be in it. So don't like place yourself like right there or right here or anything if you can't, or if you can. So kind of off to the side right there. And luckily they were smart at this venue and they put power on like a bunch of trees. So this tree has power, that tree has power, that tree has power, and then there's like three more trees over here that have power. So very impressed by that venue. Most venues usually don't put power on the trees. You're lucky if you have like one outlet, and it's usually right up front, right by the where the ceremony happens. So luckily I don't have to run a fat extension cord. But yeah, there's the ceremony setup. If you guys have any questions on how I do it, just ask me. It's a setup I've been using for a while. I definitely want to clean it up, but just deciding on how I want to do it. So yeah, we're going to get back into it. I'm not going to take any footage of the ceremony just because I like to focus, but I will see you guys back whenever we have the introductions to get started. So see you guys in a bit. Alright everybody, just wanted to give a quick recap after the ceremony. Everything went well. The officiant was actually their old high school history teacher, and this man could talk very well. So Good ceremony for sure. Microphone, spotless, no problems at all. Absolutely love it. I highly recommend the Sennheiser EWD unit. I feel like I'm trying to like beg for a sponsorship with Sennheiser. That'd be great, but I really just stand behind their product and I really enjoy that microphone for sure. Yeah, so we are doing the cocktail hour. So it's actually, they actually had all the guests roll into dinner right away. So the bride and groom told me in our consultations, is that, hey, we hate the idea of people having to wait around for food. So let's go ahead after the ceremony. We'll say the blessing and then go right into food. So while they are taking bridal portraits and pictures, everybody's eating. And then once we do the introductions of the first dance, we'll have a little bit of a break in between for the bride and groom to eat. And then we're going to roll into the rest of the formalities and then into the open dancing. So should be a decent crowd. Mostly a mixture of the older crowds. The older country is probably going to be a big hit. Maybe later on in the evening if I can get some of the sub 30-year-olds out there with some of the stuff that they like. But we'll see how it goes. So now we'll actually get you guys back into the introductions right now.
Well, everybody, sorry, forgot to film the introductions. We kind of just got moving really fast, and the last thing I thought about was to turn on my camera. It's okay, though. I kind of do the same introductions most of the time, the same way. So if you guys see my other videos, you guys see how I do my introductions. This one was honestly no different other than we had only 4 people in the wedding party, so it was pretty small. But other than that, everyone's enjoying the drinks while the couple is eating. And then we are going to roll in with the formalities for the rest of the night. Ooh, these flies in the country are crazy. But we're going to keep on moving with the night, and I'll try to catch you guys back whenever we are doing the dancing portion. We'll see you guys then. Well, unfortunately, everybody, the dancing's moved outside because this is a non-AC venue, so it's actually cooler outside. So my original dance floor is supposed to be right in front of me, but now it's all the way over here, back behind here. So I'm going to be DJing blind tonight. We'll see how that goes. Yeah, really not really sure how it's going to go, but we'll see. Hopefully it'll be all right. So I'll, no dancing clips tonight, unfortunately, y'all. So we'll see where this video takes us at the end. Not a clue.
everybody, and that's a wrap. I'm actually the last one here. They're gonna come back in the morning and clean everything up, so everybody kind of just got out quickly. So just gotta turn off all the lights and do all that. But definitely was a good wedding. They'd actually danced a lot more than I thought they would. Once I finally got the crowd going, I mean, they were dancers, they were great. So maybe I judged them a little too soon. You never know. I know we might tend to do that as DJs, but had a fun time. The dance floor was split up between outside and inside, so luckily I got a little bit of footage inside for you guys to see. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and head on home. Got about an hour and 15 minute drive home back to Fort Worth. But yeah, appreciate you guys joining in on the gig log. Like and subscribe, comment, do all that stuff. You know, if you have any questions, just let me know. I'm here to help everybody out. I want to answer as many questions as I can. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time, and thanks for stopping by. See you guys.